Welcome to MightyCall. My name is James and today I'll walk you through the user end of MightyCall's phone system. In just a few minutes, you'll learn how to set up call forwarding, customize personal greetings, use the contact book and journal, and get our mobile app. So let's get started. First, log on to your MightyCall account. From there, one of the first things to do is to set up call forwarding. To do this, go to your profile. Now, call forwarding can be different for each user, depending on how you want to answer calls. Via your cell phone, the MightyCall web phone, the MightyCall mobile app, an external IP desk phone, a traditional desk phone, or a soft phone. To enable call forwarding to an external soft phone or an IP desk phone, you'll need to connect the device to MightyCall. If you look in the bottom right-hand corner of the page, you'll see the word guides on a blue button. Just click that and it will tell you everything you need to do to set up one of those phones. Now, when you're finished with call forwarding settings, you can select whether your devices will ring simultaneously or sequentially. And while you're in your MightyCall profile, you can also review things like your call answering rules. So here you can specify how to handle calls, when your status is do not disturb, when you're busy with another call, or when there is no answer. Once again, this default call forwarding and default greetings, you can keep those, that's fine, but you can also make them more personal. So you can record custom greetings or again, set specific call forwarding rules to make them more efficient, particularly for you. And when we say answering rules, those settings apply to each user individually. So they can only be changed by the user setting them. So only you can change your answering rules. Now, when you click the Greetings and Media tab, you can change some other things such as music on hold, voicemail settings, ringback tone, and a couple other related items. And again, these are personal settings and they apply only to the specific user. So in this case, you. The journal, a very important part of MightyCall, is where you keep track of your call history, texts, and voicemails. You can filter the journal by customer requests, different types of customer requests, or by the team member who is responsible for each one. You can also listen to recorded calls and find voicemail transcripts. And for the record, voicemail transcripts will also be sent to your email, so you have a couple options on where to see them. You can also place a call directly from the journal, and in giving feedback on a call, you can leave comments on those calls that your colleagues will be able to see, so everyone knows what's going on. And the journal has another big benefit as well. When you finish a task, you can mark it as resolved to better keep track of what needs doing and who's done what. Now, the contact book, a new feature from MightyCall, this allows you to save information about your customers and see your communication history. For each client, you can add a name, email, up to 20 phone numbers, and a comment visible to all users in the account. Now, the contact book is shared by all of the users in the MightyCall account, so all of your colleagues. So when you create a user, everyone else will be able to see that. And likewise, it works the same way for contacts. So contacts saved to the contact book will be shown in the journal, the MightyCall web phone, and the mobile app, and everyone will be able to see it. You could upload contacts through the files in CSV or vCard formats straight into the contact book. To import a contact, click on the import button in the top right corner of the contacts tab. You can also add a new contact straight from the journal through your call history, or if you're adding a new contact from scratch, you just go to the contact book section and click the add contact button. Now, about the mobile app, MightyCall's mobile app is supported for iOS and Android, and it's extremely flexible, so it lets you do a lot of things. You can make and receive calls through your business number directly on your cell phone. You can read texts and reply to them directly from your business number. You can manage your status, whether that's available or do not disturb. You can add and edit contacts in the business contact book. You can leave comments on contacts and view the communication history with each individual contact. You can listen to and read your voicemails here, and you can also listen to call recordings. And lastly, you can block unwanted callers here. So the MightyCall mobile app allows you to make outgoing calls on your cell phone with your business number, the most important feature of the app, the simplest. You can use one of three methods for these outgoing calls. The best method, if you have a good internet connection, is to use IP telephony. So here your customer will see your business number as the caller ID during the outgoing call. And because you're using the internet connection, you will not be using your cell phone package data or minutes, just your MightyCall package. Now, if you have a poor internet connection, you can use the mix method. Your customer will still see your business number as the caller ID. But again, in this case, you'll be using the MightyCall package data and your cell phone package data. And the third option is if you have no internet connection, in which case you need to use your cell phone traditionally. So here your customer will not see a business number, they'll just see your cell phone number. So this is obviously a last case resort if you don't have an internet connection but have to make a call. Now, I hope these tips help you become a little bit more confident using MightyCall. As always, check out our support portal for more tips on how to work with MightyCall or contact our support team anytime. So thank you for joining.